they want to keep him happy with playing music here. That's why they started festival here. They started celebrate festival here. So look at those pillars over there. Those are called musical pillars,
yes,
which are called singing columns. We are already
correct.
Sadhus columns.
Yeah.
And in those days, 56 pillars. It was built with the 56 pillars of this building.
Okay.
And each pillar, they got more than 10 columns. And all those columns were different diameters on that, with different designs on that. And especially during Krishna Deva Raya time, all those 56 musicians used to stand by each other's pillars in that building, and they used to playing them by sandal and sticks on that. And they, all those 56 pillars, they really make different sounds.
Mm-hmm.
And at the same time that the Devadasis, the temple dancers who used to do the, they would see dancing performance inside the building. So unfortunately, this is also got destroyed by the invaders. So because of that, since last 15 years, they don't allow to get inside that building. But we can go very close by that. So they don't allow to touch those things. And wherever you can visit Shiva temple, right in front of Shiva there, we can see Nandi. Nandi is the transporter of Shiva.
Yeah.
And wherever you can visit Vishnu temple, right in front of Vishnu there, we can see a very plain pillar, which is called Garuda pillar. So this is also Vishnu pillar, Vishnu temple. Instead of the Garuda pillar, they have these beautiful chariots for Garuda.
Okay.
Because in those days, the royal family, they want to show how importance of Garuda in Vishnu temple.
That's why they have this Ratha for the Garuda.
Mm-hmm.
This is also known as the Garuda Ratha. I think of Garuda mostly.
Yeah.
The man with a winged horse, right?
Okay.
And this chariot also, it was painted, man. You can see just below the
yeah.
roof. You can see so many different colors.
Red,
green, yellow, red.
Yeah.
So this chariot is not made for it, just a showpiece.
Okay, that is.
But in those days, servants of this temple, they used to rotate these wheels by their hands. So they could rotate. Let's see this gap in between and at the bottom. So very recently, our local people, they just come on the hardly rotate these wheels by their hands.
They did.
And it becomes gap. It becomes damaged. Because of this damage, our archaeological people, they just place cement into the gap and they fix it. Now you can't protect the cement. See, elephants here. Originally, there was a horse figures here. These horses were got destroyed by the invaders. You can see it inside the chariot. You can see that Garuda. Garuda.
Yeah.
He's also a human form, sir. The man with the winged horse.
Can you see inside?
No.
And these are the beautiful pillars. The Chinese, they used to brought their porcelain. And the Arabians, there was Arabians here. They used to brought their horses out of the Arab country.
Mm-hmm.
At that time, they came through Goa. Because Goa, at that time, Goa, it was a Portuguese center. Many Portuguese also, they used to brought their horses all the way from Arabian country. So we'll go to that building and then we'll take a walk around.
The lady with the tabla.
Murganda. In those days, pilgrims of the temple they used to celebrate the deity's wedding here, and also royal family used to celebrate their wedding ceremony in this building. That's why this building is built with a beautiful statue. Look at every edge of the pillar, sir. That's in shape of banana branches. On the edge of the branch, that's in shape of banana flower. Banana is a sign of prosperity. That's why they all carved in shape of banana branch and banana flower. And on ceiling there, that is the inverted image of the lotus flower. Lotus is also a sign of prosperity. And it's well decorated with the peacocks around that flower. You can see the peacock carving.
Yes.
And next to the peacocks, you can see the dancers. They're dancing with the sticks. And most of the pillars in the building, they all depicted the story of Ramayana. You know that after marriage of Rama and Sita, so they were forcibly sent exile for 14 years.
Yeah.
At that time, they spent some couple of years in Panchavati. Before Panchavati, they went to Chitrakuta in Madhya Pradesh.
Mm.
After that, they came back to Panchavati in Nasik, Maharashtra.
Mm.
And at that time only, Sita, she was kidnapped by Ravana and he took her to Sri Lanka.
Okay.
And he fly through Hampi only. At that time, Sita Mata, she saw that Vanaras on these big boulders and she thought that she will get some help from him. And she just collects some jewelry from her body, she brought them into Hampi. And Sugriva of this place, he has collected that jewelry and he kept them. And after long time, Ram and Lakshman, both brothers, they came to search Sita all the way from Panchavati. They also came through Hampi.
Mm-hmm.
So at that time, it was heavily raining in South India. Because of the rainfall, they could not travel forward to South India.
Mm.
So they spent 4 months in Hampi. And on top of that hill, that is where Ram and Lakshman spent 4 months on top of the hill. And that is where he met Rama over there. Sorry, he met Hanuman over there. And Hanuman promised to Rama. And then he fly to Sri Lanka from Hampi. At that time, he was searching for Sita in Sri Lanka. And the demons were attacked on him. And he was fighting with them.
Mm-hmm.
Finally, Hanuman, he was captured by them. And they took him to Ravana. And Ravan, he was sitting in his palace with his own throne. And at that time, Ravan, he don't allow to sit right in front of him to Hanuman, because Hanuman was in
Manjushri.
That's why Hanuman got angry on him and he made his own throne, which is own chair, which is much higher than that Ravana's throne. And then Hanuman, he sat on his chair. And that it makes angry of Ravan.
Okay.
That's why Ravan, he ordered to set fire on his tail. And this is where they're setting fire. Look at this. Hanuman's tail and the fire stick here. And then Hanuman, he fly on the Lanka. And he burned that entire Lanka with his burning tail. That is called Lanka Dahanasa.
Okay.
After burned the entire Lanka, he fly back to Hampi.
Okay.
Then they took entire Vanara Sena from here. And they carried so many boulders all the way from here to Rameshwaram in Tamil Nadu. And then they built Rameshwaram to Sri Lanka. And then they killed Ravan over there. And again, they took back Sita to Hampi. So this part of story has happened in between Hampi and Sri Lanka. That's why most of South Indian temples and most of temples in Hampi, they all depicted story of Ramayana on their temple walls. The temple.
Mm-hmm.
At that time, those scripts were there. But everybody could not understand that scripts, you know. That's why they depicted the entire story on these pillars like this. So that everybody could understand that. So this is where Rai used to sit.
See
the
Kalyana Mandapa, no?
Yeah, that is the Torana designs around that. And also inverted image of the lotus flower.
Yeah. Again, peacocks also.
Yes, peacocks.
What is the reason?
This is called Kumbham. It's a sign of prosperity. Kumbham. Kumbham means it's like a flower vase. Okay? And you can see this Makara. Torana. Makara means crocodile face. Torana means three person, running plant.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a sign of growth.
Mm-hmm.
And on this finger, there you can see Dashavatara. 10 reincarnations of Vishnu. This is the first reincarnation of Vishnu, Matsya. This is the Kurma, and that is the Varaha, and this is the Narasimha here. So lion face and the human body. Up to 4th he came in animal form, and from 5th he started to came in human form. This is Vamana, and there are two figures, Parashurama and Rama, so both. And this is Buddha, and this is Kalki, sorry, Krishna. And the 10th one still we were waiting for, it did not come yet.
Okay.
So 500 years ago, the Vijayanagara people, they have their imagination about him. He's going to come by a horse.
Okay.
That's why they called horse with a Vishnu.
Okay.
This is also one of the imaginary sculptures here, which has got 5 different parts of animal bodies in this.
Okay.